I want to talk about Amy Winehouse demos. Here's the thing, and we got a release from Amy Winehouse a number of years ago where it was some unfinished stuff. Remember the Lioness thing? I think it was called Amy Winehouse Lioness, something like that. I thought it was cool, and I thought it was great to hear some of that. You know, by no means was it finished material or stuff that really, you know, I don't think she ever really meant to put out. Obviously, she would have finished it. But it was still really cool to hear. Our Day Will Come is on that. Tears Dry, the original version, is on that one. Lioness Hidden Treasures. That was it. Thank you. Lioness Hidden Treasures. And I thought it was a cool expression to hear somebody, you know, in that element of them recording. As it turns out, there was a whole slew of demos that wound up being destroyed by Amy's record label, which I was super surprised to discover. Apparently, it was the feeling at the time that none of that stuff would be put out because it was never really her intention. So David Joseph, who was Winehouse's label boss at Universal Music, said that there were many demos from the star that had been destroyed to prevent any possibility of a posthumous release. Joseph told The Guardian back in 2015, it was a moral thing. Taking a stem or a vocal is not something that would ever happen on my watch. Now it can't happen on anyone else's. But we have a never-before-heard demo of Amy's that I'm going to play for you here so you can listen to it. Now, how we got it is because a young songwriter by the name of Gil Sang, I'm guessing, C-A-N-G. I'm not sure how you, if it's Kang or Sang, but he's a London musician. He was writing a lot of tracks at the time with James McMillan and Marianne Morgan. They were essentially just a songwriting team, and they were pumping out a lot of stuff. This was recorded by Amy Winehouse back in 2001, in an effort for her to try and attract attention from record labels. As you'll hear, it is very not the sound of Amy Winehouse that we've become accustomed to. That raw, throwback, you know, wonderful sound that became hers. This is not that. This is clearly somebody. And by the way, Amy was 17, somebody who was trying to draw interest. And I think what's important when you listen to this, you know, especially for artists, you know, musicians that, you know, take part in the morning show with Anthony here, you know, just because you do something to draw interest is not necessarily a bad thing. Like, it's like it worked out well for Amy. Like, this is a song that is as poppy can get. And she turned out to be one of the most original artists ever. So, you know, it's okay to dabble in that sort of arena just to attract attention to yourself. You know, it doesn't mean you're going to be pigeonholed in that for the rest of your careers. And the same could go for, you know, painters and photographers and such. Like, you know, there's nothing wrong with, you know, doing honest work to show off your talents, you know, because eventually you'll get to yourself in a position one day where Amy was, where, you know, she could just do whatever she wanted. But according to, I'm going to call him Sang here, for all intents and purposes, he told the Camden New Journal, we'd been writing a lot of pop tunes, doing a lot of pop promos with various artists who would come in, many with dubious talent. It was a particularly dire time in the pop world, lots of terrible, terrible girl bands and boy bands, and we had to make something for them. So this was essentially his job, was just to write tunes for these singers so that they can draw some label interest. Here's Amy Winehouse in a never-before-heard demo of a song called My Own Way.
Do what I want.
So, by the way, I mean, this is what a demo is. Obviously, a lot of drum machine, nothing really all that deep. It's really more meant to showcase the singer, which, even though this is as poppy as heck, it really does. It really showcases her talents. In fact, Gil said at the time, quote, "Amy came in to see us, opened her mouth, and just blew us away. We were struck immediately by her talent. It was a real jaw on the floor moment. We were like, wow, yes." And as you can hear, she kills it. So if this falls short anywhere, it's definitely in the production standpoint. Her vocals are amazing. And of course, the subject matter is kind of... It sounds like a factory-written song, though, doesn't it? As far as the lyrics go, I mean. That's why But as you can see, it gives her this opportunity to, you know, show her vocal range. And that's the purpose of a demo. That's really the purpose of a demo. Knowing full well that David Joseph destroyed a lot of demos, Sang defended his decision to share the demo, saying, "I've had it knocking around for so long. I found it again last week and I thought I'll put it out there so people can hear it." I don't know if Amy really had a desire towards some of these things. You know, I'm sure at the time when she's recording it at 17, she doesn't really think that mainstream, you know, it's going to hit a lot of people, that people are going to hear it outside of the record industry. I'm sure she doesn't think that. But I don't know if she would really be opposed to it, because like I said, it's a great example for young artists. Like, you have one of the most original artists in Amy Winehouse. Her writing was ridiculous. That Back to Black album is still one of the great albums of our time. Just beautiful. Her singing, magnificent. You know, obviously she attracted the likes of Tony Bennett, who reiterated how wonderful her vocal range was, compared her to a lot of the great singers in our history. And it all started with a bad Nelly Furtado knockoff, you know, demo. But again, not her fault, you know. It's bad because the production is bad and the lyrics are, you know, very surface. But outside of that, it's wonderful because of, you know, her vocal ability, which the demo gives her a chance to show off. So I don't know if necessarily she would have a problem with it. I came across it and thought I would share it with you. So I hope you enjoyed it.